It don't tell you to cry, my brother, my sister. 5 o'clock in the morning, and here you are, all alone. Brother, you've been so worried, you don't know what to do. Oh no. But I know someone who can help you, if only you believe. Oh yeah. The sun will shine in the morning, and darkness will go away. Oh yeah. So I don't.
Master Kingdom and I'm gonna run. Welcome. We are welcoming all and sundry to this funeral service of late Mrs. Victoria Churchill. That is a international one of our kingdom.
I'm a chicken. reveal why we are coming for you.
Yeah.
You magnify it.
Thank you, sir.
Right.
We are sorry for coming late, please. We are really, really sorry.
had a hitch on the road.
But we won't waste your time.
Amen. Now, very quickly, we are going to the order of the service. And this will be the format. Members of the family will go in first. Relatives and in-laws, sympathizers and loved ones, ministers of God and the church members. Please, let's do that quickly. So we start with members of the family.
We are somehow trying to cluster everything, but we need to be careful. Praise the Lord. In as much as we will do things hastily and live here in a short while, but we need to take the processes involved. So the next thing that will happen now is that, please, there should be an arrangement for the body to be brought out here. Yes, please, I want to call on members of the nuclear family. They are going to set up something for the body to be brought out here. I want to believe that we are done with the observation. Next phase. The next phase is that all of us must stand up and then praise God. We are going to give God high praise. Hallelujah. So please, I want to call on the members of the nuclear family, wherever they are. Let them just get something here and then bring out the body. Please quickly, we are waiting, quickly. Members of the immediate family, please bring out the body so that we can continue.
Okay, please, we are begging midway by beacon. I'm not going to be so as you can be so as you while we are waiting for that, I think the people that will lead us with the praises can continue with that. Why?
All right. Hallelujah. All right. Please, can I crave your indulgence? Shall we rise up on our feet? Everybody, rise up on your feet. Rise on your feet. I want to invite the choristers, please come and lead us in high praises unto God. Hallelujah. Please loosen yourself and let's praise God. The Bible said in everything, responsibility is to praise Him. Shall we go?
We bring the sacrifice of praise into the house. We bring the sacrifice of praise into the house. Sacrifice of praise into the house of the Lord. We bring the sacrifice of praise.
The next item on in the order of service is the first hymn. So if you are with your booklet, open your book to page.
Jesus, my Lord. chapter 1, from verse 3 to verse 7. Praise be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort, who gives us comfort in all our troubles, so that we may be able to give comfort to others who are in trouble through the comfort with which we ourselves are comforted by God. For as we undergo more of the pain which Christ underwent, so through Christ does our comfort become greater. Verse 6, but if we are troubled, it is for your comfort and salvation. Or if we are comforted, it is for your comfort, which takes effect through your quiet undergoing of the same troubles which we undergo. Verse 7, and our hope for you is certain in the knowledge that as you take part in the troubles, you will take part in the comfort. May the Lord bless his word in Jesus' name.
Life's trajectory as authors is brief, as detailed in Job 14, verse 1. It is a journey which begins in birth and ends in any time, death. Ecclesiastes 3, 1 to 2. Victoria Churchill, fondly called Morita, was born on 6th of May 1972 into the family of late Wari Alabo, Festus Philip Brown, and Mrs. Clara Festus Brown of Atamunotor Diary, Bruto, in Boye Omuso Brown, Major House of Finiman in Boni, local government area of Rivers State. Her life was from the cradle, which was bearing with energy, tenacity and doggedness to adding value to family and society in general. Victoria Churchill Afamifuna had her primary school education in St. Patrick's State School, Finiman, in the then old Finiman, the present LNG industrial area. After her first school leaving examination in primary six, she proceeded for her secondary school in Finiman Girls Secondary School, Boni local government area, and upon completion, she later moved to the School of Basic Science in Obiakpan local government area to complete her O-level certificate. Victoria Churchill Afamifuna, in her sojourn in life for greener pasture, came in contact with her cherished treasure and life partner, Churchill Afamifuna Ojubebi, in Port Harcourt. The union was blessed with four lovely daughters. Victoria Churchill Afamifuna was known for her enterprising deposition and penchant for success, and trade that prompted her into clothing and restaurant business, respectively. In this pervasive and cruel world, a Christian is considered to be one who subjects to the dictate and value of Jesus Christ. Adoni in attaining stature as a Christian started in Christ Army Church, Finima, in Boni local government area. Later, when she relocated to Port Harcourt, she joined the Overcomers Ministry in Ada George Road. She was an active and visible member, no longer in faith, even until her last breath. Those who associated with her can attest to the fact that her prayer and thanksgiving, exaltation and recognition of the Creator. This value also inculcated into her progenitors. It is a fact that we grieve your transition, Morita, which is indeed a colossal and evidence of bravery, love, affection, and desire to live for your family and others. But alas, you bowed to the supreme invitation of the Creator for eternal rest. Supreme invitation of the Creator for eternal rest after a protracted battle with cancer on the 17th of January 2024 at the age of 53. Rest of victory.
Shall we be on our feet? Feet. I crave on your feet.
The solid ground, fell through the fearless drought and storm, what height of love?
Of the dead, then is Christ no reason? And if Christ be not risen, then is our preaching vain, and your faith is also vain. Ye and we are found false witnesses of God, because we have testified of God that he raised up Christ, whom he raised not up. If so be that the dead rise not, for if the dead rise not, then is not Christ raised. And if Christ be not raised, your faith is vain. Yea, are yet in sins, then they are also which are fallen asleep in Christ are perished.
Uncles and aunties, friends, neighbors, well-wishers, you're all welcome. Thank you for taking out time from your busy schedule to be here today, despite the long journey and the stress involved to come down here. We are very, very grateful. Don't take it for granted. We really appreciate you. I and my sisters and my dad, we thank you so much for coming here. God bless you very much. I just want to say one or two about my mom, Mrs. Victoria. In fact, I don't need to say too much because it's evident here. So much love. All the way from far, people came here to celebrate her. If I start talking to be as if because she's my mom, I'm praising her. But she was a good woman. A very good woman. My friends around, they know she's my friend. Like, she's the closest friend I have. The closest friend I have, and the closest friend my siblings have also. Our support system, our advisor, our prayer warrior. I can remember when I was pregnant, my mom was just like my backbone. I didn't really feel it because she was always there. She was there praying for me day and night, running errands that I couldn't go for. It's so sad that I have to say things in past tense about her. I so wish that this never happened. But who are we to question God? We love her so much. And we want her to continue to rest in the bosom of the Lord. In Jesus' name. Thank you very much.
We have gathered today to celebrate the life of a dear sister. I call her Beauty. She's a member, a full member of Overcomers Church World Outreach, Port Harcourt branch. I call her Beauty because she is indeed beautiful. She's beautiful inside and outside. She is calm, of a good character. When she says, I am coming, she means I am coming. And she is a true worshiper of God. She served in the church, even when she comes to sweep, to come to clean. And you can attest to it that it's a pity that I'm using past tense on her, but God knows best. She was a very neat and decent lady and had the fear of God in her. Our prayer is that God will accept her soul and watch over these children and the husband that she has left behind. What snatched her life will never repeat itself in the lives of the children and the members of the family, in Jesus' name.
One, she's dogged. Two, she's tenacious. And three, she has a spirit of togetherness. I remember vividly when I was in school, I had an issue and she had to call me, join me to join her. And I did that in her home. She's this kind of person who would always want to know what exactly you're going through. And at a point, I realized that she used to call me my beloved. I will tell every other person that for me, as a believer, if there is life after life, I want to have this set of sisters again. They are all wonderful. I told myself and I told God, this is the kind of woman you would like to give to me. Just the lives of my sisters. I am not putting them on the pedestal. I'm not putting them on the pedestal. But I have wonderful sisters. And it pains me so much. One testimony I have to give about her. In the month of December, I think, towards the end of December, I was in Port Harcourt on my time off. I visited her. When I was going to her place, I heard a song. And the song is Eze Bube. See how brought me. Song. But I wasn't familiar with the lyrics. So that particular day, I went to her place. I learned the song. And I never knew that she was actually believing that God will see her through. And she was, this is a particular song she will sing in giving praise to God. But to God be all glory that he seemed that she should come have eternal rest. For this I will tell her, so long, my sister. Thank you.
Let me Hallelujah. The entrance of his word giveth and understanding to the simple. With Jesus in our heart, I will invite our pastor, Pastor Lauren. Put your hands together for Jesus. All right, hallelujah. People of God, hallelujah. I know that, yes, we understand that somebody can be emotional. Hallelujah. But we must give it unto God because he's second to none. One more time, hallelujah. Shall we take this song together, please?
One more time, please. If you have not been standing up before, stand up now. Let us give it unto God. It's unto God. It's God that holds the keys of life and death. He is the first and the last. He is the Alpha Omega. He is the one that killeth and maketh alive. He's the one that knows your end from the beginning. You don't even know what is going to happen the next moment after now. So one more time, I want to beg us, rise on your feet. Lift up your hands, everybody. Appreciate the Lord. Just thank God for everything. Give him praise and glory. Bible said in everything, our duty, our responsibility, our task is to thank God. Father, we thank you. Blessed be God forever. Glory.
Lift up Jesus. Lift up Jesus.
He's Lord of life.
Hallelujah. Lift up Jesus.
He's King of Kings.
King of Kings and Lord of Lords. We shall lift him up. Lift up
Jesus.
Hallelujah, his King of Kings. Hallelujah, lift up Jesus. My God, his Lord of Lords. Yes, Lord, lift up Jesus. Yes, Lord, his King of Kings. King of Kings. Wave your hands out to him. Just give him a wave offering. Your dependency and sufficiency is in him and of him. Father, we appreciate you. Blessed be God forever. In Jesus' mighty name, we worship. Hallelujah. All right, take your seats if you can. Praise the Lord. Well, I just want to believe God to help me to be as brief could be. I know that we are running a bit behind schedule. But nevertheless, like I said earlier on, we must get things done properly. Bible said, let everything that will be done be decently done and also in order. So first and foremost, I appreciate Jesus for a day like this. And we thank God for everything, for staying away every form of confusion in our midst. And number two, I bring greetings from the father of the house, the father of Overcomers Church World Outreach, Port Harcourt Parish, in the person of Reverend Simeon Okeke, of which the significant other is just by my side here. Hallelujah. He is unavoidably absent anyway, but I just want to believe that his spirit is with us. And if we believe that, can we shout a powerful amen? And I also want to appreciate all of you that came from the nooks and crannies. A lot of you came. Chinasa came to do the testimony and said a lot of people came from far and near. So I want to appreciate all of you. The king of this community, members of this community of Abo, we appreciate all of you. In any case, members of the nuclear and extended family, we thank you for everything. We thank you for the harmony that we have seen thus far. Hallelujah. We also thank significant people that are here. Time will not permit us to begin to mention a lot of things, so we are going to break the protocols. But one thing is certain, wherever you're seated, you are being recognized officially because you are a dignitary in your own right. Can somebody say, I hear? All right, I want to go quickly to what we have to do now. I want somebody that has his Bible. Most of the times when we come for a function like this, we don't come with Bible, praise the Lord. But it's very necessary for us to always carry our soul. Because what we are doing in the moment is to take an appraisal of our life. To take an introspection of our life, to cast a deep reflection in our life, check ourselves very well. Our sister had done the race and she has finished and dropped the battle. So everything is now left for us that are alive. Hallelujah. You say it's only the fly that doesn't have an advisor that will follow corpse to the grave. Igbo people used to say, "Umana, ukokobu, nti chiria." In other words, any kind of grasshopper that the locomotive eventually kills, even with the noise of the locomotive, it means that that grasshopper is very deaf. But I just want to believe that it's nobody's portion. Can I hear amen? I also want to recognize, yeah, thank you, Holy Spirit. I want to recognize the presence of the servants of God in our midst. I know that there are white some servants of God here. Please, wherever you are, I celebrate you and I thank you for coming. So quickly, the book of Ephesians chapter number 5. I'm going to read from verse number 14. The word of the Lord said, "Wherefore he said, awake, thou that sleepest, and arise from the dead, and Christ shall give you life. See then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise, redeeming the time, because the days are evil." Father, bless your holy word and grant me utterance. Give me what it takes to dish out your word with all precision. Help me as we go in the name of Jesus. I silence every operational skin from the pit of hell. Any god of this community from the pit of hell that may want to arise against the word of God. Any kind of fortified structure, fortress that the enemy has built in the heart of man against the word of God. I bring them under subjection and under subjugation in the name of Jesus. I decree that such forces will never perform their enterprise in Jesus' name. In any case, if there is any ancient city in any way supervising missional program against the members of this community, I sack such cities right now in Jesus' name. I say I sack them in the name of Jesus. I sack them in the name of Jesus. If they have been operating before, they operate no more. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Redeem the time. We may want to capture it anything. Hallelujah. Of blessed memory, Victoria Churchill has done her own bit and she has dropped the baton. I am so happy. In respect of the testimonies that I have so far, even though they were so brief, but they were direct. And the testimony from the daughter, I want to tell you that the daughter did not fake anything. My father, Bishop N.E. Moses, that had gone to be with the Lord, made a statement, and I quote, "If you fake to fake in life, very soon the person will fade out." So I want to tell you that she did not fake anything that she said. Everything that she said is something that I can give witness or credence to. And in the testimony of our mama here, mama also said a lot of things about her. But well, I want to give my own brief testimony before we continue. Victoria Churchill is somebody that has worked under me. I said in the night of the service of song in Robert Thomas Church, Port Harcourt Parish, I'm privileged to be the leader of the outreach team. And this lady in question worked under me as an evangelist. I don't know, maybe most of you here may not know, but that's true. And one thing I mentioned that night is that whenever we want to go out,
One thing
that you cannot take away from her is coming out very early. And when she comes, she will
excite us. There is need for us to go out. And she increased in that tempo. When she came out from the hospital, the very first time, she increased in that tempo, doing everything conscientiously to please the Lord. So if you ask me, I don't have any iota of doubt where she is. But like I said, this message is for us that are alive. Time is something that rules your life. The measure of your life is in time. So whatever you do with that content, whatever you do with the content of time, will so determine the legacy you will live with time. Look at the life of this woman. Because she did a lot of beautiful things, beautiful testimonies, we have been dished out. Look at the brother, what the brother said. The brother said that even if I come this world again, I want to have sisters like this. You are not dying, you know. Can I hear somebody say amen? I say you are not going to die. Can I hear you say amen? Do you know why you are not going to die? Because you have not fulfilled purpose. So everything that God wants you to do here, you must fulfill all of them in Jesus' name. So that when you are going, you will go empty. You are not dying. But reflect a bit. That's where I'm coming. Reflect. What if somehow, not you, maybe another person, is lying down here? We are on pilgrimage here on earth. And there's a place that is a song without time. It's not a figment of man's imagination. Heaven and hell, they are not the imaginations of the mortal mind. So what are you doing with your time?
In time? Or are you investing time? Because it's either way. It's either you waste time or you do what? Invest what? Time. And that's why the Bible said, walk cautiously, circumspectly, so that you can redeem that time. So what am I saying? If I want to bring it down, are you still standing as
reflect?
Time will not permit us to say all sorts of things, but let's leave it. There will be another time, but not on this same matter. There will be another time that will call for celebration in another way. Bow down your head. Begin to talk to God. Talk to Him. Are you the one that kept something in your house? Are you the one that they tell every time to come here and here? Come in the midnight. Funny enough, they will tell us that you are doing something stupid. But you see professors and technocrats being called to the street. Can you not jam your hands in the honor of God?
Sure.
If you have a sense of loss, if you have love for the family, can you stand up? Let's pray together unto Him. In Jesus' name. Our Father in heaven, we thank You. You are a good God. You are He who does not sleep and you do not slumber. You are the Lord God of heaven and earth. We give You praise and glory in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we cannot hear for the loss, for the demise of Your daughter. And we're standing anointing kingdom glory to decree that such evil will never repeat itself in this family in the name of Jesus Christ. We come against every wickedness, the root cause of this wickedness. It shall never come back again in the name of Jesus Christ. It shall not be named among them in the name of Jesus Christ. Whether it flows in the blood, whether it flows in the spirit, it shall never find a place in their lives in the name of Jesus Christ. We stand as the body of Christ, we set a decree over their lives. No evil shall befall them in the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever that will rise in contention, whatever that will rise in opposition, whatever that will rise in wickedness against this family, will stand together as a family with decree, it shall not stand in Jesus' name. Neither will it come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. This evil they saw, they will not see again in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We will set a decree from this day, the goodness and the mercy of God shall follow them. In the name of Jesus Christ, God will send men for them. In the name of Jesus Christ, their mother was a help because he left an inheritance. He should see men shall come to their rising. In the name of Jesus Christ, women will stand for them. In the name of Jesus Christ, every tongue that will rise against them in the open, in the secret, to speak wickedness, to speak evil, to do incantation, to do enchantment, to speak ugly words, to raise cursing, they shall swallow it in the name of Jesus Christ. Such wickedness will not stand. It shall not see the light of the day in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. But we decree that the glory of God and the power of God and the goodness of God shall continually be their portion in the name of Jesus Christ. You will live in sound health. You will live in sound mind. You will live in overflow of God's mercies in the name of Jesus Christ. We lift up our voice to decree, every messenger of the devil that shall come into your family to cause confusion, to confound your language, to divide you, as he is coming, or he or she is coming on the way, shall perish on the way. In the name of Jesus Christ, whoever that will come to turn your face against each other, no matter who the person is, God will root him out, root her out. In the name of Jesus Christ, your mother stood for unity. Unity will stand for you. In the name of Jesus Christ, she's an epitome of love. Love shall speak for you. In the name of Jesus Christ, she says strength wherever she is. Strength will always be for you. The arm of Jehovah will continually be underneath you to support you in everything, for everything good. In the name of Jesus Christ, you will succeed. Your son never says, but it's the beginning of the rising of your son in the name of Jesus Christ. I bless you in the name of God the Father. I bless you in the name of God the Son. I bless you in the name of God the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus Christ. No agent of darkness, spiritually, physically, will use the space of your mother, your sister, your wife to work against you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Nobody will use anything that concerns her to set evil in motion in the name of Jesus Christ. She has gone to rest. She only serves as a witness from up there, and that's what she is. Whatever that stakes her face are born with faith in Jesus' name. Blessed be the name of the Lord God Almighty. We know you are blessed in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hello, good evening. My name is Steve Williams, once you grew. Let's see the microphone one too.
Lord, hallelujah. Like I said, your mother has done his very best, okay? On all of you, our prayer is that when Abraham died, God still blessed them, Isaac. God will bless all of you in Jesus' name. So I hand over this to you sincerely from the depths of our heart. And God, with this seed, will open up more doors for you, your siblings, your father, and the members of your family, in the mighty name of Jesus. All right.
My name is Comrade Shedrack Brown. I'm a nephew to the deceased. It's a sad one for all of us, being members of our family, that today we've lost our dear aunt. We've lost our dear mother. We've lost someone so dear to us. She was a selfless person in the family, humble. In fact, she cared for everyone. I just have to say that we can't question God. It has happened. To him be all the glory. For us, members of our family that she has left behind, is for us to take strength from our personality, is for us to learn from our life and those principles she believes, and then stand more united as a family. Thank you.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Eternal Father, we thank you. We give you praise and glory. Even, O God, as I speak you, O God, to bring us all of us into your fold. We ask that you grant us the grace to stand firmly on that solid rock. In the name of our Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, for my glory and heavens. And I guess, and amen.
Amen.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this wonderful opportunity. Thank you for everything that you have done in the life, O God, of your daughter. Thank you also, O God, for all the provisions. Everything that was put in order, O God, for this successful funeral. Thank you for taking us thus far. We give you praise and we give you glory. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus. Father, O God, we sign the confession of your word. And we make this confession in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' mighty name. To everything there is a season, a time to every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which has been planted.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Father, again, in your word,
First Thessalonians
chapter number four and verse number 13.
Running to verse
number 17.
And it says, but I will not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them
which are asleep,
that you sorrow not,
even as others
which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, them also we see in Jesus will God bring with him. Can I hear amen? For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord,
that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord
shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Can I hear amen?
Amen.
Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them
in the cloud
to meet the Lord,
and in the air
so shall we be ever with the Lord. In the name of Jesus.
No interferences from the people of hell
will ever arise from here in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every program of Satan to use our face to disperse even the peace of the members of the family, Lord, I override and overrule. And I decree, declare that something cannot stand in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Whoever in any way that we use our face to play divination, to play invocation, enchantment of any sort, Father, your word said in Isaiah 48:22, no peace for the wicked, says our God. Whoever that person is, even they are orchestrating it in an advance, I withdraw peace from them in the name of Jesus. For the third time, I withdraw peace from them in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I decree one more time, no evil man, no evil woman will ever tamper with this grave.
Amen.
Will ever tamper with this body.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I decree that this body will be here.
Amen.
Till that resurrection morning.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
O Lord Almighty, whose Son Jesus Christ was laid in a grave, bless this grave, we beseech you. Grant Victoria Churchill, whose body is buried here, today with you in your heavenly paradise. In the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son,
in the name of God the Holy Ghost,
in the mighty name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, I show the entire vicinity with the blood of Jesus. One more time, I cover everyone.
everywhere with the blood of Jesus. For a third time, I cover everywhere with the blood of Jesus.
Bro,
lower the body to the ground.
Can you give me the shovel?
You are shovel, sir.
Earth to earth. Ashes to ashes. And dust to dust. Hallelujah. Right, is there anybody in the media family? Please, can you come? Yes, please, people that want to.
No, the daughter, where daughter? Chinasa.
Please, the daughter, prepare anybody.
Chinasa, give Chinasa.
The daughter, prepare anybody.
Give Chinasa, man.
The children first, please. The children first.
Let me give this house. You don't see the forest, what they call it? You like clay.
Hallelujah. And setting up the hope of resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. Can I get an amen? Who shall change our vile body that it may be like unto his glorious body, according to his mighty working power, whereby he is able to subdue all things to himself. Can I get an amen? May the blood bless the Gloria Church and give her eternal rest right now and forevermore, in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
All right. Shall we do the Lord's Prayer together? Please, even the one that has seated, can we not do the Lord's Prayer together? In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost, shall we go? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth, as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we are forgiving those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation. Deliver us from every evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever, in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. All right. Can we begin the fire? Please lead us right now as we begin to cover the grave, please. Okay. In Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Father, we thank you, we bless your name. Thank you for our brothers and sisters, in particular of our sister. Thank you because at the beginning and at the end, Father, we appreciate you for giving up, for guiding, for everything about this day. As we are declaring this ceremony open, people close, Father, we decree that anyone who not by God shall be his or her destination simply in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, we shall be not the God that is not by. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit.
Ladies and gentlemen, please.
We have given you all to know you are not one of the greatest things you can live. Thank you for coming. I'm also not here to recognize our four union. They are all here in our midst. Heavily loved by Honorable Emmanuel Ogu. Honorable Emmanuel Ogu. We recognize the present.
Please, let's make sure the colonels are very well on the various table. The colonels are the drink. While the children and the three families should also get prepared to arrange the various table as we do the official presentation of the colonels. And quickly, let me call on a musician.
I'm a friend of Churchy, a very close friend, my very good brother, a trusted fellow, a friend. Indeed, I'm more or less like a brother. As you can see, we come all the way from Port Harcourt just to greet this occasion and to pay the last tribute to the wife, whom he loves so much. We sincerely pray and wish that God Almighty will be with the family at this trying time. Our heart and our spirit are with them. We are about leaving, but our spirit will always be with his family. We pray that God also will give him the fortitude to bear this irreplaceable loss, because he has come a long way with the woman, and of a truth, there is a very big bond between both of them. Like I said earlier on, the night that the woman gave up, I was the first person he called to brief me that his world has gone to an end. I was like giving him some kind of motivating words of encouragement in order for him to find solace in God, which we believe that God will always give him and his children, the lovely daughters whom the wife have left behind, the fortitude to bear this irreplaceable loss. May God Almighty continue to strengthen them and give him this grace to overcome this trying time. We, our colleagues, we are all living. Some came from all the way from Warri, some came from Asaba. We came from all the way from River State, Port Harcourt to be precise, and we are going back to our various destinations. We also pray that God, with his infinite mercy, will grant us journey mercies to our various destinations in Jesus' name.
For the successful conclusion of this funeral, in honor of our sister of blessed memory, Victoria Churchill. From the testimonies that we have heard so far, we are quite certain, convinced, and that our sister lived a very good life. A life that was not selfish, a life that actually impacted on the people of her generation. A life that will always make her generation to remember her for good. Our prayer is that as God blessed Isaac after the death of Abraham, that God in turn will continually bless the children and bless the entire family in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus.
I am Pastor Mrs. Okeke, late sister Victoria Church Hills pastor. She was a good lady. She was. Her counseling, her management, her organization is so wonderful. She's so cleansing as well. So I thank God for her life, but I'm praying for the family that God will help them to bear the loss and bless them in Jesus' name. Amen.
Take it all, take it all.
brought to you by All Stars Entertainment 2.